Hello, wrestling fans. This is Jim Cornette, and you're watching IHWE TV. Weekly Pro Wrestling is back on television in the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex.
From Oxford, New York, weighing in at 195 pounds, the mind of wrestling, J.T. Lamotta.
I thought he retired.
And his opponent, the Terry Gordy Memorial Cup winner.
He's back.
From Charlotte, North Carolina, he weighs in at 228 pounds, Thomas Shire. This match scheduled for one fall. 15-minute time limit. Rick Manning, your referee.
All right, Doyle King bringing the match to the ring. The global wrestling legend.
Doyle King.
Now appearing with IHWE. Matt Avery here with Johnny T. And we've got a good one for you this week. We've got a couple great matches, starting off with JT Lamotta, Thomas Shire, this week on IHWE TV. Matt Avery.
You know, I never liked Lamotta much. I know this guy for years, and he finally retired, did his big tearful farewell, you know. And there he is, back again. Like a rash or something.
Well, you know how those wrestling retirements work, or a wart, maybe, right?
Yeah, I've retired a few times myself.
Well, we're fortunate to have you back, Matt Avery.
Yes, you are.
We have gotten at least one or two cards in the mail from people saying how much they really appreciate your jokes and one-liners here on IHWE TV.
Yeah, and then a few that didn't appreciate, because we need to be calling the action right now. Thomas Shire in control of the mind of wrestling. Shows you how dumb wrestling is.
Well, Thomas Shire, you know, you've seen it here on IHWE TV. He's the winner, the inaugural winner of the Terry Gordy Memorial Battle Royal. What a big honor that was for Thomas Shire, and an accomplishment.
Absolutely, and not only that, then he took Johnny Gargano to the limit, and Johnny Gargano had to pull out all the stops to beat Thomas Shire.
Right, Thomas Shire, in a lot of great moments at IHWE TV, and right now with JT Lamotta to the ring. These guys look like they've scouted each other quite well. Oh, Thomas Shire mocking the mind of wrestling JT Lamotta.
I don't think he was mocking him. I think he was paying homage to him. You know, he's supposed to be the mind of wrestling.
That didn't look like he was paying homage to them.
Homage.
We got a... Oh! We had a test of strength going on there.
Leave it to Lamotta to take the shortcut. Get it, shortcut.
We might get another one or two cards about those great jokes that you tell. Twisting the wrist of Thomas Shire is JT Lamotta. JT Lamotta with a lot of good chain wrestling, a lot of good holds early in this match. Oh, right on the elbow, ramming. I mean, he had his hand back on the mat and then just stepped right on his elbow. He could crack a wrist that way.
Well, Lamotta trying to take a strength advantage away that Shire has. You can see how well that worked.
Shire with the rollover pinning combination, two, almost three. Good, solid, consistent three count by Rick Manning.
See, Shire's a kid. He's still growing. You know what I'm saying? He's a young guy, still growing into his body. So he's still exceptionally quick. Only 228, 230 pounds, something like that. I guarantee this guy, by the time he hits the height of his career, he's going to be 275.
Well, I tell you what, there's no doubt that not only in his physical stature, but also in his wrestling career, Thomas Shire, still a young man, like you said, his upside is unlimited. Oh, JT Lamotta. Couple.
Wow.
Threw a few forearms to the face. They're out on the floor, brawling. Oh, another forearm to the face. That's the third one he's taken.
Oh, he hit his back of his head on the post.
JT Lamotta in a world of hurt here, but he gets out of the way, the mind of wrestling.
Oh,
I tell
man.
You what, there's a lot more give to the back of Thomas Shire than there is to that steel ring post, Matt Avery.
Well, Lamotta, again, showing why he calls himself the mind of wrestling.
Not even close to a fall there.
Well, you know, this all goes back to Shire making the mistake, like he did with Johnny Gargano, of trying to shake his hand in a show of sportsmanship. And we live in a world where sportsmanship don't count for anything anymore.
Well, that certainly seems to be the case here tonight. Now, JT Lamotta, like, stretching him out and kind of like a surfboard-type maneuver. Oh, and the knee to the back. JT Lamotta with a lot of the kind of mat, kind of Greco-Roman type moves he seems to have going. I don't know if Thomas Shire expected all that from JT Lamotta, though he probably should have. He is the mind of wrestling.
Well, Lamotta, you know, he's a great technical wrestler. Where he gets himself in trouble is he goes for all these high spot moves and high wrist maneuvers and gets himself in trouble. I don't like the little spare, but look at one, two, almost a three. But when Lamotta wrestles like this,
5 minutes gone.
Much as I hate to say it, he's hard to beat.
Well, I tell you what, Lamotta really seems to be on his game. And that suplex taking the bigger man Shire over, very impressive by Lamotta. He certainly hasn't been sitting on the couch eating potato chips while he's been off. Almost pinned himself there.
Well, you know, Lamotta is, one of the things that he's done is, oh, wow, nice back elbow. He's actually taken some time to learn some sambo, some judo. So he really has expanded his craft quite a bit.
Shire ripping the ropes, reversal. Oh, big elbow. But Shire has just been hammering on Lamotta. Forearms, elbows.
Shades of Harley Race.
Wow. Now that is some old school style wrestling. That's the kind of action you can see here on IHWE TV weekly. Old school meets new school at IHWE, Matt Avery.
Nothing better. Oh, wow. Twisting side suplex.
One, two, this could be all, but no. Lamotta kicks out. Not enough yet. Shire did go for the pin quickly. Shire critical of Rick Manning's three count.
Well, yeah, it's because it's slow. Just like him.
Seems like every week you're on IHWTV, you have less than complimentary things to say about Rick Manning. Southern Wrestling Hall of Famer referee Rick Manning. Oh, the sleeper hold. The sleeper hold and putting all his weight on Shire, making Shire carry his weight around.
Well, Manning has to make sure he's not choking him out at the same time. And as for the Hall of Fame thing, you're a Hall of Famer, so, well, I rest my case.
Deep thoughts by Matt Avery. What a maneuver by Lamotta. Oh, what's he going for here? Some sort. Oh, he's getting him locked up.
The La Shizzle.
You are something else today, but look at this maneuver. JT Lamotta's got him just locked in.
The Lamotta lock. How about that? Is that better?
He's going for the ropes. The Lamotta lock, we'll call it, for lack of a better term. Looks like kind of a modified version of kind of a STF Japanese style maneuver. Like you say, Lamotta has studied all styles and forms of wrestling. He can whip anything out of his wrestling toolbox at any time. He let go pretty quickly. Now he's got a five count there to lay off the hold. Lamotta playing it clean and letting the hold go right away.
That's unusual for him. And it was stupid for the mind of wrestling. That's what that five count's for. Oh!
Oh, went for the super kick. Hit him from behind the head.
Grazed him with that enziguri, but it was enough.
Kind of a mid-range enziguri.
Oh, man!
Wow! Sliding clothesline, two count only. When Lamotta, I think at this point, Lamotta's getting a little frustrated. He's wondering what's it going to take to put Thomas Shire down for a three count.
Well, as we've seen with Shire, you know, like when he wrestled Johnny Gargano, Gargano hit the lawn dart on him and it didn't finish him. He had to kick him in the face to put him down.
That's true. He's very resilient, this Thomas Shire. Knee lift. Oh, kick to the head.
Oh, wow.
Two. And that's it. Thomas Shire just planting him down. You're a winner. Thomas Shire.
KO'd him.
We'll be right back, folks, with a big match. Mike Foxx and Seth Shai.
Ladies and gentlemen, 9 minutes, 58 seconds. Your winner, Thomas Shire.
This is Jim Cornette. I'm excited to tell you I'm coming back to the Metroplex. For the first time in almost 20 years, I'll be appearing live at a wrestling event in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. It's Sunday, September 28th at the Sendera Center in Fort Worth when IHWE presents Old School Hustle. It's going to be a super spectacular card with great names like Texas Hall of Famer Stan the Lariat Hansen, Barbara Goodish, Kyle O'Reilly, Billy Anderson, Charlie Haas, the IHWE champion Matt Riviera, and so many more. And on September 28th at 2 p.m. that afternoon, I'll be hosting a special live Jim Cornette experience, a Q&A session with you, the fans in attendance. You got to be there. Old Time Wrestling is back in the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex, and I'm proud to be a part of it Sunday, September 28th at the Sendera Center in Fort Worth, Texas, when IHWE presents Old School Hustle. You got to be there. I'll see you in Fort Worth on September 28th.
Lamotta, you return to the ring tonight on IHWTV against Thomas Shire. You didn't walk out with the win, but you walked out with the respect of the fans.
The respect of the fans. I've always had the respect of the fans, Johnny. At least I feel like I did. But you know, Thomas Shire did exactly the exact reason why I wanted to face him tonight. He pushed me to my limit. I was not the better man tonight. 9 months away is a long time. And what I'm looking forward to now is Tim Storm. Tim Storm, you got anybody else back there? You think that I'm washed up? You think that I lost it? Tim Storm, let me tell you something. I'm the mind of wrestling. I'm going to train harder. I'm going to run harder. I'm going to do everything faster, bigger, stronger. And I promise you that, because everybody knows when I put my mind to anything, the outcome is usually not so good on the other side.
Fans, look for this situation to develop in future weeks right here on IHWE-TV.
Hey, this is a grappler, and I'm coming to you from IHWE Wrestling from Fort Worth, Texas. Weekly wrestling every week. Catch it, folks, and beat it if you can.
Thomas Shire, you just got out of the ring with JT Lamotta, the Mind of Wrestling. You came out with the victory, but I think Lamotta also answered some questions that the fans may have had about where he's at in his wrestling career as well.
That's right. You know, I stated in an interview about, a week ago, that JT Lamotta, even though he's been out for 9 months, he's still been training. Because when you're a true athlete, when you're a true professional, just like JT Lamotta, when you're the mind of professional wrestling, you don't stop, you don't quit. And I believe, yeah, JT Lamotta showed everybody here tonight that he still has the fight in him. And you know, Thomas Shire, a young lion, and JT Lamotta to go out there and fight and crawl, just like he's been doing his entire career. After 9 months, he almost had me. But you know what, Lamotta, I got you. And you did the respectable thing. The one thing that I wanted more was I beat you and you shook my hand. And that takes a true professional.
Ladies and gentlemen, Thomas Shire, victorious yet again on IHWE-TV. Thomas, we look forward to seeing what's to come of your career and follow it here on IHWE-TV.
Follow it, folks.
Without the main event, without the main event, without the main event,
there is no show.
We're back, IHWE TV, Johnny T along with Matt Avery, and the main event, Mike Foxx.
The main event. Without the main event, there is...
Well, there's still a show, there's just not a main event. It's kind of faulty logic there,
astute
Foxx.
Astute observation, Matt Avery, very astute.
Man, I miss Rob Moore. What's up, man?
He's like, you know, he's like the scout leader. We need him.
I know this guy. Seth Shai going out there. Hope he's got some disinfectant wipes.
Seth Shai firing up the crowd.
Seth always looks so happy.
He was intense. A lot of fans of Seth Shai out in the crowd.
I wonder how many tickets he had to buy.
Nah, just kidding.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your semi-final event of the evening. Weighing in at 235 pounds from Phoenix, Arizona, the former IHWE champion, main event, Mike Foxx.
Well, Mike Foxx with a few fans.
And his opponent, who hails from Egypt. He weighs in at 225 pounds, a three-time DFW champion, Seth Shai. This match is for one fall. It has a 30-minute time limit. Rick Manning, your referee.
Now, these are definitely two of the heavier hitters in the IHWE.
Well, it's weird because these guys, they have been foes and they have been friends. And man, I tell you what, when they were part of the establishment back in the day in IHWE, they pretty much ruled the place.
Well, Matt Avery, at the moment, in the ring, it's all business, and I don't think there's any friendship going on right now.
Well, you know, you got to remember, professional wrestling, it doesn't have to be a war. These are two guys competing for a spot, yes, but it doesn't have to be a bloodbath.
Oh, Mike Foxx. Pushing Shai back. Shai looks a little bit surprised. Shai is just so intense.
Yeah, that's one way to describe him. He's intense. That's why his psychiatrist has him on the heavy meds.
Headlock. Reversal of the headlock. Take it over down to the mat. Oh, what an athletic maneuver by Foxx, and he takes the hip toss over and takes a powder. Foxx can't believe it. Seth Shai was right there to counter it.
You know, Seth looks a lot leaner than I've seen him. He's dropped 20 pounds, man. He's quick right now. You had a conversation not too long ago with Seth Shai. Matter of fact, I talked to several of these guys back in the locker room, and I hate to say it, but our champion, Matt Riviera, he's not a real popular guy.
Well, when you're at the top, everybody's looking to knock you down.
But you know, I think it's like what Franco DeAngelo said a few weeks ago. How did Franco, Seth, Foxx, they built this place to make it what it is, to make it possible to be in places like this in Sundara Center and have international TV. And then all of a sudden, Franco goes on the shelf, the show goes on the shelf, they come back and Matt Riviera is the champion. And it don't sit well with any of these guys.
Well, I agree with you to some extent there, Matt Avery, but there's one way to take that title off of Matt Riviera at this point. What's happened in the past doesn't really matter. They're going to have to pin him in the ring 1-2-3 in a championship match.
And Johnny T, I know you're David Fuller's buddy and you're there in the office with him. How many title defenses has Matt Riviera had? And who did he fight? Ashton Jacobs. Really? What about Mike Foxx? What about Seth Shai?
I think David Fuller, Commissioner Black Bart, there's going to be many opportunities for a Seth Shai and a Mike Foxx. In fact, I would say, Matt Avery, that the winner of this match is very likely to move into contention for a potential title shot.
What? A three-time DFW champion, the face of the franchise. You got Mike Foxx here, a guy, former champion. Why do they have to do anything to be in the title picture? They automatically should be in the title picture.
What?
Oh.
You are a coward. I'm disqualifying Mike Foxx. Hit the referee, your winner, Seth Shai.
What?
That's it.
Wow.
Mike Foxx disqualified. Mike Foxx disqualified for hitting the referee.
I'm disqualifying Mike Foxx for putting his hands on me. Therefore, your winner, Seth Shai.
You know what?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, your winner of the match by disqualification.
Oh! Blocked him. Wow.
I can't believe this.
That's an assault on a senior citizen.
I cannot believe Mike Foxx going after Hall of Fame referee Rick Manning.
Oh, it's Black Bart.
Here comes Black Bart. He's got that branding iron with him.
Oh, man, things are getting out of hand here.
Black Bart restoring order.
I don't think Mike Foxx is scared.
I'll wrap this damn branding iron right around your damn neck, boy. You suck it. Don't even put another hand on him.
Uh-oh.
Oh, Matt. That is a total lack of respect.
That's a $1,000 fine, buddy. Keep it up. If we can add it all up, it don't matter. It don't matter. You don't put your hand on the referee unless it's by me, brother. You don't do it, period.
Jiggalo James Johnson coming out.
He's coming out to help out Rick Manning. Somebody needs to.
He might need a hip replacement.
$1,000 fine. We saw Black Bart take an order last week with that $1,000 fine on Kevin Cross. A total lack of respect for authority by Mike Foxx on a Hall of Famer.
Oh, good Lord.
Wait, what is Seth Shai doing now?
He just broke Johnson's neck.
Well, wait a minute. What's going on here? I don't understand.
Oh, you know what this means, Johnny T? The establishment is back.
This is unbelievable, Matt Avery. It was, the fix was in the whole time.
Oh my, he almost put him through the ring.
Poor Gigolo, he just came out to help Rick Manning, and now look what's happened to Gigolo James Johnson. We need some help out here. Does anyone from the locker room dare to come out and try and help out the Gigolo? What a force this is going to be.
Oh, the establishment is back.
Look out, IHWE. Mike Foxx and Seth Shai.
Wow.
Formed an unholy alliance.
The last time they did this, along with the late Matt Bourne, and interestingly enough, David Fuller, they turned this business on its ear.
There is no show.
Wow, well, that's going to be a force to be reckoned with, Johnny T. No question.
Unbelievable events this week on IHWE TV, Matt Avery. Next week, we have a huge DFW Championship match with Americos, the champion, defending against Ashton Jacobs, Gregory James, in a big three-way DFW title match. That coming up next week on IHWE TV. Unbelievable what went down this week, Matt Avery.
Insane. This place is completely out of control. Somebody's going to have to do something about this.
Well, fans, we'll see you next week on IHWE TV.
I'm going to give you my experience, because I was bullied and continue to get bullied to this day, but that's okay.
You can take away from this, anybody who's going through any kind of hard times or who is being bullied or you're going to bully yourself, I would like to stand up here in front of you and say that when you get to get grown at all, that it goes away, that people don't bully you as an adult, or that it really doesn't. I know that's not the most positive message, but my point is part of what you do is defined by how you react to tough situations, not by the situation. I want you to know that it's never going to go away. There's never going to not be bullying. But you're always in control of how you react to it. I don't know who to give this quote to, but one of my favorite quotes of all time. I remember Randy Savage saying, but I don't know who to help. There's a tough times don't last, and tough people do. I mean,
folks, I'm not much bigger now than I was in school. So I dealt with it every day. I was scared to death of speaking in front of people like I am right now. I couldn't do it. I only friends with my parents and a couple of other guys. I loved wrestling, but back when I went to school, it wasn't cool. You get bullied for disliking wrestling. I wore a wrestling shirt, and I got bullied for it. But you know what? I had wrestling. And at the age of 15, one of the worst experiences of my life, the worst day of my life, happened when my mother passed away. She was 38 years old. And it just happened. It wasn't no long build-up. It just happened. So then it was just me and my father. And then a year later, I turned to pro wrestling, and I met a man by the name of Johnny McIntyre, and he took me in, and he said he would show me the ropes.
I was a kid in school that was not just bullied, but was bullied every single day. And it did affect me as a kid. You know, and that's something I think some bullies forget or fail to realize. It's, you know, you hear these things, and you hear one thing and you can dismiss it. You hear two things and you can dismiss it. You hear three things and you can dismiss it. And we get this stuff every day. And I was all through middle school, going into high school. I remember my freshman year of high school. I was a jeans and a t-shirt guy, and I liked video games, and I liked wrestling. And I wore movie t-shirts to school and stuff, and there were these people that would bully me. They were finding an excuse because that's who they were. There was nothing wrong with me. There was nothing wrong with how I was dressed or what I liked or anything like that. But they had some sort of justification in those guys because they're not doing any of this. I'm doing what I love in spite of those people who are on the same time as fighting
me. I didn't even know I'm a small guy. You know, in high school, it's the usual thing. If you're small, you're kind of picked on here and there. But on top of that, they would ask me, you know, hey, what do you want to be when you grow up? I would say, I want to be a pro wrestler. And they would be like, you know, well, what can you contribute to pro wrestling? You know, you're this little guy, you're like, what? Like a buck 10, what are you going to do for pro wrestling? And eventually, I played football my freshman year. Sophomore year, I actually quit football to join pro wrestling. As long as you are, no matter how tiny, how big you are, there is a place in the world for you, and you can achieve greatness no matter your size, your age, or your stature. Thank you.
Got back. where I felt like alone or become a loner or turn to drugs or, you know, different types of things. But I did it. I focused on athletics. That helped me a lot of hustle. And it's a bad, bad thing. So it's not cool. Bullying is not cool. I don't like bullies. I tell my children, stay away from bullies. If there's a problem, always reach out to someone, okay? Because it needs to stop right away. If you see your friends being picked on, make sure to protect them and take care of them.
IHWE founder David Fuller, and David, next week you're stepping in the ring to referee the big DFW title three-way match.
Well, you know what, Johnny T? I want to be a part of a moment. I want to be involved in the moment. You got three of the future stars of Texas. You got Americos. You got Gregory James. You got Ashton Jacobs. They killed it a few weeks ago right here on IHWE TV. And next week, I guarantee you, fans, you are in for the match of a lifetime. They're going to make IHWE history. They're going to make Texas wrestling history for the Dallas-Fort Worth Championship. You've got to be here next week on IHWE TV, and I'll be the man calling the action.
Fans, next week, David Fuller, special referee, DFW title match, Americos, the champion, puts it on the line against Gregory James and Ashton Jacobs, the rematch, IHWE TV.
Big splash, a suplex, a muscle flex. Are you a contender or pretender? One arm bar and you're a star. Texas, death matches. Bend down the hatches. Figure four and you live. No room here for with my iron claw. We'll break your jaw, my clothesline line is really fine. A mid-ring crash, the big splash, a suplex, a muscle flex. Are you a contender or pretender? One arm bar and you're a star.